difference. As you know, we have started our chapter excretory products and their elimination, and in the previous videos we discussed about the three different modes of the excretion of nitrogenous waste. तो इतना हम सब कुछ कर चुके हैं. Now in today's video we are going to discuss about the excretory organs of invertebrates, जिसमें हम lower और higher invertebrates सबको include करेंगे. And we will see how these organisms, these animals, they excrete their waste. So we are starting from the lower most and we are starting with the protozoans. So सबसे पहले हम start करते हैं protozoa group से. We are starting with the protozoa. So protozoa, and then when we start the animal kingdom properly, we will start. We find the porifera group there. हमें फिर मिलेगा porifera group, and after porifera we can see that next phylum is the cylindrata. Cylindrata or cylindrates, cnidarias, जिन्हें हम बोल रहे हैं. These are the different groups of animals. These two, porifera and cylindrates, are animal phylum. So अगर हम पहले इन तीनों की बात करें, all these three groups, these do not have any specific respiratory excretory organ. इनकी बॉडी में किसी भी तरीके का excretory organ नहीं होता. And all of these three, ये तीनों ही जो है अपना nitrogenous waste जो है वो ammonia की form में excrete करते हैं. Means we can say that they are ammonotelic. They are ammonotelic and they excrete their nitrogenous waste through their body surfaces by diffusion. So यहाँ अगर protozoa की बात करें, in the protozoa we can include the amoeba, we can include the paramecium etc. and porifera, sponges आ गए हैं. All these they do not have excretory organs. So अगर हम amoeba की बात करते हैं, amoeba से हम start करें. Amoeba is an aquatic organism which is living in the water. So as the nitrogenous waste, ammonia is formed in its body. This ammonia is directly released out. Is directly released out through diffusion through this body. So इस तरीके से यहाँ पे इसकी body से ammonia का excretion होता है. And all these they are living. If they are living in the marine environment, then they show this kind of excretion through their general body surface. अगर हम porifera की बात करते हैं, तो porifera has the canal system. वहां पे हमें कैनाल सिस्टम देखने को मिलता है. अगर आपको याद हो, हमने एनिमल फाइलम किंगडम में भी इस पॉलीफेरा फाइलम में पढ़ा था, डिफरेंट काइंड्स ऑफ कैनाल सिस्टम्स आर देयर. सो इन द कैनाल सिस्टम्स आल्सो हेल्प इन द एक्सक्रीशन ऑफ वेस्ट. एज द वाटर कम्स एंड एक्सक्रीट आउट, वाटर जो है बाहर निकलेगा कैनाल सिस्टम के थ्रू. विद दिस एक्सक्रीटेड वाटर, और जो बाहर वाटर निकल रहा है उसके साथ एक्सक्रीशन भी हो जाएगा. इसी तरीके से जनरली मीन्स जनरल वे में ही एक्सक्रीशन हो रहा है. देयर इज नो स्पेसिफिक excretory organ is there, but if these organisms which are included here like protozoa, porifera and cylindrata, we cap these into the fresh water. Agar hum inhe fresh water conditions mein rakhte, ya if they are found into the fresh water condition, then what they found, there will be a specific structure is formed which is known as contractile vacuole. So in the condition, in the general marine condition, they do the excretion by the simple way, by diffusion through their body surfaces or by using their canal system etc. But if they are fresh water, at that condition they have formed a structure that is known as contractile vacuole, and this contractile vacuole also used for the maintenance of their osmoregulation. So contractile vacuole yahan pe excretion aur sath mein ऑस्मोरेगुलेशन का भी काम करेगी. सो यू दैट थिंग यू हैव टू कीप रिमेंबर, इन जनरल दे एक्सक्रीट थ्रू देयर बॉडी सर्फेसेस, बट इफ दे आर कैप्ड इनटू द फ्रेश वाटर, देन एक्सक्रीशन विल बी डन विद द हेल्प ऑफ कॉन्ट्रैक्टाइल वैक्यूल. सो दिस इज अबाउट दी थ्री ग्रुप्स ऑफ एनिमल्स. नाउ नेक्स्ट फाइलम इज प्लेटिहेलमिंथेस. दे आर ऑल्सो नोन एज फ्लैट वर्म. अगर आपको याद हो, इस फाइलम में हमने प्लेनेरिया, टेपवर्म्स, लिवर फ्लू इनके बारे में बात की थी. तो ऑल दीज वर्म्स, how they excrete their nitrogenous waste, let's discuss. When these worms or these flatworms, they are found into the aquatic environment, then they excrete their nitrogenous waste in the form of ammonia. So if they are found present in the aquatic environment, then nitrogenous waste is ammonia. Whereas if they are present in the parasitic form, agar parasites ki form mein kisi bhi host ki body mein agar ye present hai, in this situation they excrete their nitrogenous waste in the form of fatty acid. तो वहां जो एक्सक्रीशन होगा वो फैटी एसिड की फॉर्म में होगा. सो दिस इज अबाउट दिस प्लेटिहेलमिंथेस. नाउ अगर हम एक्सक्रीटरी सिस्टम की बात करें, एक्सक्रीटरी ऑर्गन की बात करें, दे डू नॉट हैव एक्सक्रीटरी सिस्टम. सिस्टम यहाँ पे भी नहीं है, बट दे हैव एक्सक्रीटरी ऑर्गन. एंड दिस स्पेसिफिक एक्सक्रीटरी ऑर्गन विच इज फाउंड इन द केस ऑफ प्लेटिहेलमिंथेस इज नॉन एज फ्लेम सेल्स. उसे हम बोलते हैं फ्लेम सेल्स. दीज फ्लेम सेल्स आर ऑल्सो नोन एज प्रोटोनेफ्रिडिया. दे आर ऑल्सो नोन एज प्रोटोनेफ्रिडिया. प्रोटोनेफ्रिडिया एक इस तरीके की स्ट्रक्चर है, जिसमें क्लोज मीन्स दे हैव क्लोज्ड, they have not opening outside. यहाँ पे कोई opening नहीं है जो directly excretion को कर सके. They are a closed structure. That's why we are calling it protonephridia and also known as flame cells. As you can see here, the structure of flame cell is shown. This flame cell has a bulb-like structure that is known as flame bulb, जिसे हम flame bulb कह रहे हैं. And this flame bulb has some cytoplasmic projections. बाहर की तरफ projection दिखाई गई हैं. Through these projections, what happened? Through this projection, in projections के through flame cells जो हैं, they receive the nitrogenous waste from the coelomic fluid or the from the tissue fluids. तो ये flame cells एक ऐसे ही system में मिलेगी, एक ऐसे organisms में मिलेगी जहाँ पे circulatory system present नहीं होता. So what is the these flame cells they are doing? They are receiving the nitrogenous waste. Nitrogenous waste जो है वो नीचे अंदर इन flame cells के अंदर आता जाएगा through the tissues. And then they are released out. नीचे से जो है excretory tube like structure जो है उनके through वो बाहर release हो जाएगा. As you can see that inside the flame cells, this cytoplasm, ये जो एक आपको hair like structures दिखाई दे रही है, these are the cilias. ये क्या है? These are the cilias. These cilias they keep vibrating or keep moving. जैसे flickering होती है, flame की flickering होती है, like this this do flickering. उसी वजह से इन cells को हम flame cells कहते हैं. So this is about the excretory organ of platyhelminthes. Now move to the next phylum, that is ascalhelminthes or roundworms. Ascalhelminthes or roundworms, in which we have studied about the ascalis. आपको याद हो इस phylum में हमने ascalis के बारे में पढ़ा है. So these are the roundworms which are found in this phylum. Now let's see how they excrete their nitrogenous waste. Most of these roundworms they are ammonotallic. They excrete their nitrogenous waste in the form of ammonia. And excretory organ. अगर हम excretory organ की बात करें, these roundworms they have a specific type of excretory organ which is known as Rennet cells. जिन्हें हम बोलते हैं Rennet cells. These Rennet cells are also known as H-shaped cells or H cells. इन्हें हम H-shaped cells भी कह सकते हैं. These cells they excrete the nitrogenous waste, but rather than excretion they do osmoregulation. Their chief function is osmoregulation, but उसके साथ साथ excretion भी है जो करेंगे. अब इन्हें H cell या H shaped cells क्यों कहते हैं? Here you can see the diagram of these H cells or Rennet cells. Here you can see that these H cells they have some longitudinal external excretory canals. इसमें longitudinal excretory canals present है. And these excretory canals they are connected through the transverse canaliculi. Transverse canaliculi के through connected है, जो दोनों के बीच में दोनों H-shaped cells को इन्होंने connect किया हुआ. तो आप यहाँ देख सकते हैं एक side एक canal है, this another canal is there, and between the canaliculi network is present through which disconnected. And upper side of these canals, excretory canals, you can see the excretory pore. वहाँ पे excretory pore है, and through this excretory pore, they excrete their ammonia. So these are known as H cells or the Rennet cells, which are found into the phylum Ascalhelminthes or roundworms. So this is about the roundworms. Now let's move to the next phylum, which is annelids. Annelids, जिसके अंदर हमने nereids, earthworm और leeches, इन सब के बारे में पढ़ा है. These annelids, they have the segmented body. And in these segmented bodies animals they have specific respiratory organs which are known as nephridia. तो यहाँ पे excretion का जो काम है वो एक specific structure करती है जिसे हम बोलते हैं nephridia. These nephridias are highly means convoluted structures and they are arranged segmentally. These segments में ही arrange होते हैं. At different segments these nephridias are formed. अगर हम excretion की बात करें, इससे पहले कि हम nephridia की structure discuss करें, in general the annelids which are found in the aquatic form they excrete their nitrogenous waste in the form of ammonia, whereas the land surviving, जो land पे annelids present है, they excrete their nitrogenous waste in the form of urea. तो दोनों ही तरीके से excretion हो सकता है, depends on their condition where they live. अगर हम nephridia की structure देखें, nephridia they have upper funnel shaped structure which have the cilias at their margins. This funnel shaped structure is collect this funnel shaped structure of the nephridia. They collect the coelomic fluid. यहाँ पे इसके आपको इस तरीके से cilias नजर आएंगी. Anterior part जो होता है आगे का part nephridia का funnel shaped structure है जिसपे cilia present है, and these cilia they receive the coelomic fluids. Coelomic fluid को receive करेगा यहाँ से body cavity से. तो यहाँ पे fluid जो है वो nephridia के एक part के अंदर आ रहा है. This part of the nephridia is known as nephrostome. It is known as nephrostome. So it's nephrostome. It's collect the synovial fluid from the body cavity and then it leads to a convoluted tubular part. इसके बाद यहाँ पे इसमें बहुत convoluted होता है, बहुत ही ज़्यादा convoluted होता है. हम इतना show नहीं कर रहे, we are just making the simple diagram. So you can take an idea from this also. It's a convoluted tubular structure is found and the last part of this nephridia is known as nephridiopore. The last part is known as nephridiopore. So it's a nephridiopore. Now let's see how it's do the excretion. कैसे होगा? This nephrostome it's receive the synovial fluid from the body cavity. This fluid is enter into the inside the nephridia through the nephrostomes. Now that this transitional जो यहाँ पे transport membrane है, यहाँ पे जो इसकी inner membrane है, they can reabsorb the water and the important salts. जो भी absorb करने लायक चीजें हैं, they can reabsorb here in this tubular patch of the nephridia. Then the waste which remain, उसके बाद जो waste बच गया, it can release out through the nephridiopore. So the waste is released out through this part, that is the nephridiopore. So in this way, this excretory organ they work in the annelids and the specific structure known as nephridia. In general, the nephridias which are found in annelids is also known as metanephridia. So these kind of nephridias are known as metanephridia. So this is the excretory organ of annelids through which they excrete their nitrogenous waste. Now the next phylum is arthropoda. Let's see how the excretion happens in the phylum arthropoda. As we know, arthropoda is the largest phylum. It consists many groups. So they have different types of excretory organs according to their requirements. Let's start with the first one, that is crustaceans. In the crustaceans, we include the prawns or crayfish. These prawns or crayfish, they have the excretory organs which is known as green gland. The excretory organ which is found in prawns and crustaceans is known as green gland. As you can see, the structure of this green gland has the upper sac-like structure which is known as ant sac. And this ant sac, it remains connected through another structure which is known as labyrinth. The labyrinth is connected and the labyrinth is open into a sac which is known as bladder. It's a involved bladder. And these bladder connected with the labyrinth through a nephridial canal. So this ant sac is received, is extract the fluid from the cilium or from the body cavity. This fluid then move through this labyrinth and through the nephridial canal and finally the waste is reached to the bladder and it gets stored there. In between, all the useful materials get absorbed by the other part of this green glands. So यहाँ पे इस वजह से अब green gland का नाम green gland क्यों रखा गया है? क्योंकि यहाँ पे जो nephridial canal region जो हमें दिखाई दे रहा है in some crustaceans, this is of green color. So green color होने की वजह से these are known as green glands. So this is the excretory organ of the crustaceans, green gland. Okay, next group is the insects. जिसमें हम insects include कर रहे हैं and basically the insect which we are discussing is the cockroach. So in the cockroaches, the excretory organ is known as Malpighian tubule. It's known as Malpighian tubule. So these Malpighian tubule, they do the excretion. This Malpighian tubule, they do the excretion. They work as an excretory organ. This Malpighian tubule, they are present with the, you can see the structure. These Malpighian tubules, they are found at the base of the midgut and at the junction of the midgut and the hindgut. तो ये digestive system के साथ ही present होती है Malpighian tubule cockroaches के अंदर and they do the functioning for excretion. They also receive the excretory, they receive extract the fluid from the gut and from the hemolymph because they have the hemolymph, they have open circulatory system. So hemolymph से waste को extract करेंगे and then they release it. So this is the structure of Malpighian tubule. Next one, अगर हम बात करते हैं arachnids, in the arachnids we include the spiders and scorpions etc. Spiders, scorpion, ये यहाँ पे include जाएंगे. इनका the excretory organs होता है, that is known as coccal gland. In coccal gland, all Malpighian tubules can also be found there. Except that the millipedes, centipedes, which are also arthropods, in which the excretory organ again Malpighian tubule is there. तो वहाँ पे भी Malpighian tubule के through excretion होगा centipedes और millipedes में. ये हो गई बात हमारे phylum arthropoda की. Now let's move to the next phylum, that is mollusca. Some mollusks have one or two pair of kidneys. These kidneys they are known as organ of Vaginus. So this organ in Vaginus, they are that excretory structure which is found in the mollusk. This organ of Bajra's has two openings. The one opening at one side they open to the pericardial cavity, whereas the another opening is found towards the ventral. So this organ is Bajra's is work as an excretory organ in some mollusks, whereas in some another mollusk, one more type of organ is found, which is known as Kuiper's gland. This Kuiper's gland is found near the rectum. ये rectum के पास मिलता है and it's also helping to the excretion. So these two are the different excretory organ which can be found in the case of mollusk. And अगर हम बात करें type of excretion, how they excrete their nitrogenous waste, chiefly or almost all the mollusks, they are ammonotallic. They excrete their nitrogenous waste in the form of ammonia, but the land living mollusks, they are uricotallic. तो अगर वो land पे रह रहे हैं तो वहां पे जो excretion होगा वो uric acid की form में होगा, so they will be uricotallic. So this is about the phylum mollusk. Now the next phylum, that is echinodermate. तो अब हम बात करते हैं echinodermate की और echinodermata. In the echinodermata we talk about echinodermates, they do not have any specialized excretory organ. किसी भी तरीके का specialized excretory organ यहाँ पे जो है वो नहीं मिलता. They excrete their nitrogenous waste through their thin wall of tube fit. Tube fit जो structure है जिसके through ये attached रहते हैं. These tube fit they help the excretion. So tube fit के through यहाँ पे excretion हो रहा है. No other specialized organ यहाँ पे excretion के लिए नहीं मिल रहा. और echinodermates में अगर आपको याद हो examples हमने देखा है यहाँ पे starfish, sea urchin, sea cucumber वगैरह वो सब animals यहाँ पे included किए गए हैं. Next phylum is Hemichordata. Hemichordata has a specialized structure for their excretion which is known as proboscis gland. And you know in the Hemichordata we studied about the balanoglossus. The next one is Urochordata. In the Urochordata we studied about the Hydmania. In the Hydmania the excretory organ known as neural glands. Next one, cephalochordates, where we studied about the amphioxus. They have the excretory organ, they also known as protonephridia. These are protonephridia like structures are there which help in the excretion. And then after that we move to the vertebrates, and the vertebrates have the specialized excretory organ which is known as kidney. So kidney is present in the higher vertebrates. So that's all about all the animals, the invertebrates and the vertebrates about which we studied, that what kind of excretory organs are present in their body. Now we will start with the next topic in the next video, that is human excretory system.